We are going to look at the surface area of a prism. First, let's recap the parts of a prism. Prism has two bases. One here, one here. The distance between the two bases is the height. To find the total surface area, we add the area of the two bases and the rectangle in between. The width of the rectangle is the height of the prism. Same kind of. And the length of the rectangle is the perimeter of the base. So orange with orange, blue with blue, green with green, and yellow with yellow. Therefore, the total surface area equals to 2 times base area here and here plus the perimeter of the base times the height. So this the green is the yellow and the orange. Earlier on, we said that surface area equals to 2 times the base area plus perimeter of the base times height. This formula works for any solid with uniform cross-section. For example, look at this solid with a semicircular cross-section. This is the base, and this is the height. And to find surface area, you take 2 times the base area plus perimeter of the base, which is this thing, times the height. Now we'll look at the volume of a prism. For this solid, observe that the base area is 3 square units and the height is 1 unit and the volume is 3 cubic units. So when we have 2 layers, the base area will still be equal to 3 square units, but the height will be equal to 2 units. And the volume will be equal to 6 cubic units. This shows that volume equals to base area times height as 3 times 2 equals to 6. So when we have half a layer, in this case the blue layer, we take the base area remains as 3 square units, but the height changes to half a unit and volume will be equal to 1.5 cubic units. Let's look at an example of how to find the surface area and volume of a prism. To find the surface area of a prism, first, shape the base. Then circle the height. Now let's calculate the base area. First, let me redraw the base. From this diagram, we can see that it is a trapezium. So base area will be equal to half times the sum of parallel sides times the height. It is obvious that these two sides are parallel because the angles here are 90 degrees each. So base area will equal to half times 6 plus 9. And the height of the trapezium is 4. So times 4, which will be equal to 30 cm squared. Now let's calculate the perimeter. So perimeter will be equal to 6 plus 5 plus 9 plus 4. To find the surface area, we have to take 2 times the base area plus the perimeter of the base times height of the prism. This would be equal to 2 times the base area, which is 30, plus perimeter of the base, which is 24, times the height of the prism, which is 7, equals to 2 cm squared. With this work, we can easily find the volume. Volume equals to base area times height. This would equal to base area, which is 30, times height, which is 7. This would equal to 210 cubic centimeters. Now let us look at this solid with a semicircle as its uniform cross-section. First, shape the base. First, you have to calculate the base area. Let me redraw the base. This is a semicircle where radius is 4 cm. So base area will be equals to half pi r squared, which equals to half times radius, which is 4 squared, equals to 25.123 cm squared, 5 cm. Now we have to calculate the perimeter. To find the perimeter, we have to take half 2 pi r, which comes from this, plus 8. This will be equal to half times 2 times pi times radius, which is 4 plus 8, equals to 20.566 cm. To find the surface area, take 2 times the base area plus the perimeter of the base times the height of the solid. This would equal to 2 times 25.123 plus the perimeter of the base, which is 20.566, times the height of the solid, which is 6. This would equal to 174 cm squared. From this work, we can easily find the volume. Volume equals to base area times height. When we take the base area, which is 25.123 times the height, which is 6 cm. This will give us 151 cm cubed. Observe that the base area is 3 square units and the height is